Hey friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey. I'm a web designer. Now today we're going to be talking about how AI can give us freelance web designers superpowers in our businesses. From automating repetitive tasks to organizing our notes, the possibilities are only limited by our imaginations. Now here are 9 ways that AI can give us superpowers today. Help us work smarter and not harder. Let's go. One of the ways AI can help us freelancers is through something called generative design. Now this AI tech allows you to generate a wide variety of design options based on set parameters and constraints, enabling you to create really unique and creative work. It's great for finding inspiration, mock-up ideas, creating product images and mock-ups and so on. There's a tool called Midjourney. Now there are other AI art tools out there, but we're gonna talk Midjourney for a moment. It's a cutting-edge website, program, software, and it helps you create unique designs and AI art based on simple text prompts. Now, it's currently in open beta. Anyone can give it a try for free. I pay for the pro account because I ran out of prompts pretty quickly. Now, with Midjourney, you can create concepts and digital art that is simply not possible for most people, and it can help you bring your imagination to life in an artistic and visual way. Like for example, creating furniture mockups for a luxury Italian brand. You gotta watch that video and add it to your watch later list. It's pretty good. Now the best part is, it can save us a lot of time and effort, allowing us to focus on other more critical aspects of our freelance businesses, like client management or marketing or service fulfillment. Creating content is a ton of work, especially when you're juggling client work and family life, like myself. Now AI makes it a complete non-issue. From content ideas to catchy headlines, article structuring, even B-roll suggestions for videos. It's insane how much faster you can produce quality content for your business. AI can help you organize your thoughts and bullet points and then turn them into a blog post draft and then break it down into, let's say, a Twitter thread and create a content calendar for your social media, all with a few simple steps. I'm talking minutes. Now, caveat, just make sure with any content that you publish that has your name on it for your business, make sure you proofread it, personalize it, and make it your own before you hit publish. Also, remember kids, plagiarism is bad.
You want to get a detention?
AI can be a real game changer for freelance designers in the early stages of a client project. So here are a few examples of how it can be used. Number one, generating design concepts based on a client's creative brief and industry trends. Now this can help the designer come up with a fresh and innovative idea or fresh and innovative ideas that align with the client's needs and goals very quickly. The second would be creating a mood board or a series of mood boards that align with the client's brand, target audience, and the objective that they're trying to achieve. Number three, assisting in research for a project, finding patterns and competitor trends, industry trends for unique ideas. The fourth would be analyzing competitors' websites, their brand strategy, their content strategy, to reveal areas where you can help differentiate your client's strategy and gain them a unique competitive edge. And number five would be generating initial sketches, wireframes, and lo-fi prototypes for client feedback. Now, AI can help us freelancers stand out and impress clients in these ways, and it can streamline our work and make it more efficient. But you gotta remember that our competition also has access to these very tools. So, a rising tide lifts all boats, they say. In order to stand out, you're gonna have to use your imagination and your unique personality to explore the possibilities of AI. Now, the more we play around with this, the more unique and interesting our work is gonna be. It's a win-win situation. Now, speaking of AI possibilities, another powerful tool is voice recognition. Now, with this, we can transcribe voice notes accurately on the fly, dictate emails, and even control software with just our voice. Voice recognition and dictating is not a novel idea, but just imagine this. Imagine being able to focus on what you're creating while giving commands to your computer to assist you in your work, like having a personal assistant alongside you. Now, where I think this is really important is that this technology has massive positive implications in the world of accessibility, especially for disabled people. Imagine you're a programmer and you lost the use of your hands. Before AI, there really wasn't much that you could do about that. You'd either not be able to type at all or type very slowly. But now, with the ability to conversationally communicate your programming ideas to AI-assisted tools like ChatGPT in whatever programming language you need, you can make specific changes and requests and casually communicate to your AI personal programming assistant to do the coding for you based on your specific prompts and ideas in your head. It's like translating what you have here through AI to what you're trying to create. This is amazing. Creating summaries is how we mere humans condense large amounts of information into something a little bit more manageable so that we can synthesize and recall all the important bits. As freelance designers, we often have to read through a lot of information like notes, transcripts, books, articles, you know, chicken scratches from that conference we attended for inspiration, research, and to help us accelerate in our business. But sometimes we just don't have the time to read everything in depth, or we don't have the time to read at all, depending on what we're up to at that given moment. Now that's where AI-powered summarization tools come in handy. For example, I recently came across an article discussing who owns the copyright of creative works created by artificial intelligence. Instead of reading the entire thing, I was just curious. So I used an AI tool to give me a summary, and I even asked it to explain to me like I was in the fifth grade. It said, when something is made by a computer, sometimes it's hard to say who owns it because it wasn't made by a person. So grown-ups are trying to figure out who should own it, and it's a tricky thing to decide. Here's another cool idea. You could record a client discovery meeting, transcribe the audio with AI voice recognition, then pass the transcript into an AI tool like ChatGPT or Jasper AI Chat, and have it write a short summary with key takeaways and even action steps for you and the client. It's a lot of cool ways that we can use AI for summarization, and it can help you come up with new ideas, stay informed about industry trends, and most importantly, save you a lot of time that you can then reinvest into something much more valuable for you and your clients. Author and entrepreneur David C. Baker says, "It's hard to read the label from inside the jar," which simply means you need an outside perspective to gain insight on your business, your products, your personality, your marketing plan, and a lot more. Mentors, online communities, accountability partners, these are all external resources that can help us understand our own problems that we might not be able to see from inside the jar. But AI can augment this for us as well. So here's how. For example, freelance web designers can use AI to help them think of new ideas for their business and their services. AI algorithms offer a way to quickly examine data, which can help find patterns and trends in the market and help us come up with new concepts that we can take action on. So if you're a designer whose only income source is simply through client work and performing services, there are other ways that you can generate additional income sources that may be more scalable or passive in nature. You know, the whole getting paid while you sleep. By giving AI some context into your target market, your business goals, and other relevant information, you can ask it for ideas for product development, as well as ways to standardize your services or find ways to make what you're doing better, more efficient, or eliminate unnecessary tasks that you are doing. Now, in this way, AI is going to help provide an outside the jar view of your situation so you don't miss out on critical or valuable opportunities. We've all got the same number of hours in a day, but when you work for yourself, there's a lot of things that you have to do that just ends up falling on your shoulders. For example, you may have to design websites for clients, make new content, take breaks, plan out your business, do paperwork, bookkeeping, email responding, and if you don't know how to manage your time well, you're going to lose track of your time and feel like you're never getting ahead, because you will never get ahead in that way. Time blocking is a technique that solves that problem. Time blocking is where you segment your day into specific chunks or blocks of time devoted to a certain task or theme or activity. Now, here's an example. When I need to be ultra productive and I got a lot on my plate, or an upcoming project that has a deadline, I break my day into two time blocks, 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. for the morning block and 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. in the afternoon for the afternoon block. During the first half of my day, I allocate all my energy and focus solely towards completing a critical task, such as creating a video script until it is finished or until the time block is complete, noon, whichever comes first. In the second block of 3 hours, I give priority to a secondary task, something that is not as important as the first block. And let's say, for example, responding to clients, email management, or responding to members in the Creative X crew, which is my free community for people like you. You should definitely join if you haven't already. The link's down in the description. Now, it's important to mention that I also turn off all distractions and I only focus on that task or activity in that block of time. No multitasking allowed at all. It took me years of trial and error to finally hone in on a technique that worked for me when it came to my time management. Now, unfortunately, I still struggle with staying organized at times, haphazardly scheduling tasks, letting people take certain chunks of time, and I forget about the very system I created for myself, and it all falls apart pretty quickly until I have to scramble to put it all back together again. Humpty Dumpty, right? This is where I think AI will revolutionize this area for freelancers who need to run a tight ship, especially solo business owners like you and I. AI-powered scheduling tools, like for example, Use Motion, can be used to automate tasks such as, you know, task management, calendar organization, making it easier to plan and prioritize tasks without having to figure out how you should be optimizing your schedule manually. You know how it can be a real pain to keep track of all your notes and ideas? Well, AI-powered note-taking, I think, is gonna change this entire practice. Imagine being able to use your voice to access your own personal AI assistant, and this assistant can keep track of everything from notes and ideas that you jot down to journal entries, summaries, in a digital second brain. AI-powered note-taking is the key to making this happen. I don't think this is available yet, but it's certainly on the horizon. Like, just think about this. You take notes, you write down company minutes, you write down your ideas, inspiration from that conference that you just attended it the week prior, and when it comes to finding that one important note or trying to synthesize what was key in that meeting or to find out what you should do about it, it's kind of like searching for a needle in a haystack. But with AI-powered note-taking, it's kind of like having your personal librarian accessible at all times for all of your notes. And because of AI algorithms, it has context and it can see the big picture, allowing for more efficient retrieval and automatic categorization of data, making it easy to find what you need. Plus, it may even be able to suggest patterns and themes within the data of your notes, making it way easier for us to comprehend, understand, and summarize and put that information to use. Just imagine taking these notes throughout the year and you say, at the end of the year, I want to review everything that I wrote down. Give me some key summaries. Categorize it by month. You know, what was I thinking that month? What ideas did I write down? What were all my business ideas this year? What of those ideas seem to be more viable? Just imagine how much more effective you'll be at gathering data and taking notes, and you don't have to worry about how do you find it or how do you turn that into something. You don't no longer have that graveyard of cool business ideas. Maybe there's something in there that you could follow. You're drowning in emails, right? Yeah, me too. If I skip email for like a couple days, my unread email quickly balloons to an uncontrollable 3 to 4 figure number. And because I feel The obsessive need to get to inbox zero, I block off significant time each week just to clean it all up, delete the junk, unsubscribe from newsletters, respond to important email, and get it back under control. Again, until the next day, when it's back to crazy town. As a freelance designer, it can be tough to keep up with all the messages and still have time to focus on the important tasks. But here's the deal, AI is gonna change this completely, and I'm totally ready for it. In fact, it's already here. Superhuman is a tool, and I'm sure there's a number of other ones as well, which uses AI technology to automatically triage your email. Like the technology that's used in spam filters, it automatically kind of just puts it away, puts it in the spam folder, but it's in reverse. It detects and highlights your most important email so you can quickly get to the important messages and never miss that email from a potential client or partner again. And this is just scratching the surface. AI is going to help you organize emails by importance, eliminate decision fatigue, that mental fatigue that you always experience when going through emails. Should I read this? Should I respond to it? Should I snooze it for later? Just imagine the time you'll save and how great Inbox Zero will feel every single morning. So good.
Deleted.
So remember, with AI, we can work smarter, not harder. If you want to continue the conversation and connect with like-minded creative professionals, I'm going to invite you to join the Creative X crew. The link's down below. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more videos like this one, and I'll catch you in the next one.